I would like to welcome all of you. Some faces are familiar, some are new. Welcome to all of you, and welcome to our guests, our Swedish guest, and our Miloš from Serbia, and Marco, my co-moderator. Thank you for being here. My name is Helen Larsson, and I'm the culture counselor at the Swedish Embassy. We are this year promoting creativity, entrepreneurship, and innovations, and we do that together with this museum, Museum of Science and Technology. And for some of you perhaps know that this project is in three parts. It's this exhibition over there about innovations from Sweden. It is our pedagogical program for children between 12 and 18, where they are developing their own ideas. And it's this Monday club at the museum. This Monday, we are having Marie and Annika from Bolon, a very, very successful company, family company from Sweden. And we are having Miloš from Ivković, also a very successful Serbian company.
For us, it was very important to add passion for what you're doing. We say, if we're going to take over this company, we of course want to do that in our way. And if you're going to succeed, you really need to have passion what you're doing every day.
As Marie said, it started in 1949. Oh, I have to show. I have the very first prototype with us, actually, not really the first one. But it all started in 1949 with a very traditional carpet that our grandfather did. And that's how the Bolon name also came up, that you use cotton, which is bomull in Swedish, and nylon, which is nylon. So this is a very, very first original. And then our parents took over, then they had their business idea. And then Marie and I took over, and then is what I believe became the really true Bolon succès, which I think we are here to talk about today. How can you make quite a traditional weavery into an international design brand?
And that is so much us.
So when we took over the business 2003, you know, one day from the other, you can't just change traditional in the company. Our parents, you know, they had a weavery. They got orders, they got production, and they selling without any strategy. Marie and I sat down that day when we said, okay, we took over the business, but we wanted to do what we believe in and what is passion for us. And we know that fashion, design, interior has always been attraction to us. So why don't we add that to this product? And that is exactly what we did. Became a design brand. Add this in a totally new packaging. And run a company is 24 hours a day work. So you need to have fun. You need to have, as Marie said, a lot of passion for going to the work every day. It's hard sometimes.
And I also want to say that I was on the way to say before that the flooring business are very boring, very conservative. And we put fashion into the flooring business, and we get a lot of people say, what are they doing? Are they crazy? You cannot add fashion, you cannot add design to something that is very traditional. We always believed in our own thoughts, and we didn't listen at other one who was negative and say, you cannot do like that. We always have gone our own way. And we know today that this was the great success, that you always believe in your stomach and what you feel is right for your company. And our ideas is really what have bring us there we are today, that we always believed in ourselves, and that we actually revolution a whole business like the flooring business, that today we know that even if we're not a very big company, we know that the huge company, they watch us today and they see what we're doing, and we are putting the trends today. This has been very successful to always think positive. It's never ever that we are accepting a no. We always say you can always do it, and I think also a very important part for us has been that we have a long-term planning, that we know where we're going to be in 5-10 years, because when we know that, we know that each day you need to take decision, you take the right decision. Because if you don't have any future plans, you don't know what's right, what's wrong. But if you can see you already succeed 5-10 year in the front, you will also be there. I also want to say it's very important to invest in a good team around yourself. Because for us, it has been very important that we have, in some case, people that are much better than us. We are very good what we're doing, and we know what we are good on, but we are not good at everything. So you need to have really good people in your company to grow, because you have to have people who want to grow, who want to develop themselves, and want to be in a fast company who is not a traditional company. So this we have also seen that's been a very important key for the success, together with all of the things we're talking about here tonight. Mm-hmm. And also the passion, and also really that we all the time see possibilities in everything. We're traveling around the world all the time. We could never be successful to sit home in our office in Ulricehamn, the city of 20,000 people, to know what the markets need out there. You need to be there. You need to go out and visit your customer. You need to be around and just feel the impulse that you get inspiring, that you're going home, and you take all this impression with you home to make it like bullion for us, and to put it into our collection, put it into our communication, and how we will present ourselves.
We have working now on a 5-year plan in 2016, and that means we will double our turnover, and both in square meters and figures. We will challenging the market and be on top, be in front, and that you can only do when you are driven by the heart. Right, it should feel right in the heart, and with the right passion and a lot of happiness on the way there. It's not the goal who is the most important, it's a journey to the goal. I think that's very important to remember. We never had the problem as far from now to employ the right people. And I think, first of all, it's a family passion inside the company that everyone is the same,
We have a good renommee, know, in our commune, in our neighbor.
Yeah, we are. Boulogne is an attractive company to work on. Even we have people like 120 kilometers around us. And we take care of the people. We are doing things together. There are no barriers between the production and the office people. One for all for one, almost, I would like to say.
Bih htio da se zahvalim organizatorima što su mi dali priliku da učestvujem na ovom događaju. I stvarno se radujem što mogu da podijelim jedno iskustvo koje moje porodica i ja imamo i naši zaposleni u tom nekom putu našem razvojnom, koje to traje već 25 godina, a moje već 15 godina. I također mislim da je jako lijepo, jedna jako dobra prilika da možemo da uporedimo razvoj jedne domaće porodične kompanije sa iskustvima iz nekih drugih zemalja, pošto u porodičnim kompanijama, i čak i moje, ja nikad nisam radio ni u jednoj drugoj firmi osim u ovoj, tako da neka iskustva koja sam sticao i koja sam dobijao su bila isključivo kroz taj rad koji sam imao, i dosta puta smo mi postavljali pitanja kako je to negdje drugo, zato što prosto nemamo iskustva rada bilo gdje. Mislim, ja dosta često danas kažem da je neznanje odigralo jednu jako bitnu ulogu u našem razvoju. Zato što mi se čini da smo tada znali ono što znamo sada, bi mislili da ovo nije moguće. Jer je to sve toliko udaljeno u svakom smislu jedno od drugog, da stvarno je teško bilo tada i zamisliti da uspjesi koje mi danas imamo i neku pažnju koju svojim dizajnom privlačimo, prosto to nije bio naš fokus. Naši su prioriteti u tom trenutku bili stvarno na nekom mnogo nižem nivou. Ono što je interesantno je to da moja majka koja još uvijek kod nas radi u firmi i danas ona ima jedno zvučno ime kreativnog direktora, iako ona ne voli sebe da naziva ni dizajnerom, niti kako na tom nekom smislu, ali ipak koordinira rad jednog dosta uspješnog dizajn tima, je oduvijek insistirala na tome da to što mi radimo mora biti jedinstveno dizajn. Mi smo se tu dosta puta sukobljavali, ali prosto te neke njene ideje su usađene u korijen, u osnov onoga što je danas naš dizajn, što su naše kolekcije, a to je stvarno insistiranje na dizajnu i vrhunskom kvalitetu. To što mi radimo vama može da se sviđa ili ne sviđa, ali kvalitet nam ne može osporiti niko. Znači tu prosto ni u jednom trenutku nije došlo do nekih kompromisa. To što smo mi doživjeli tada je u stvari nam dalo jedan impuls, dalo jednu ideju da stvarno pokušamo da i prodamo i da to što proizvodimo isporučimo negdje na tržištu izvan Srbije. Nekako se Njemačka nametala logično jer smo imali podršku da izlažemo na sajmovima u Njemačkoj. I 2005. godine u februaru smo mi prvi put u stvari samostalno predstavili jednu svoju kolekciju na sajmu mode u Düsseldorfu i to je stvarno doživjelo jedan veliki uspjeh. Interesantna je priča prije toga jer ipak Srbija nije baš neka zemlja koja je prepoznata kao mjesto odakle možete da kupite modu ili koje možete da kupite. Ona je imala dosta jaku tradiciju tokom 80-ih godina u proizvodnji tekstila, ali kao zemlja u kojoj se proizvode i tekstil uslužno za neke poznate svjetske modne kuće. Ali da baš jedna modna kuća dođe iz Srbije i na taj način dobije pažnju na tako bitnom sajmu, prosto nije bilo za očekivati. Jer mi smo dosta duga prije toga, u stvari tokom cijele 2004. godine, pokušavali da nađemo neke partnere. Pokušavali smo da nađemo, ne znam, neke agente ili distributere, ljudi koji će da rade s nama, koji će da tu naš proizvod zastupaju. I ili su uslovi bili prosto nerazumni ili ih uopšte nije bilo. U svakom slučaju mi smo tada 2005. godine otišli da prodajemo bez ikakve ideje kako ćemo to u stvari da isporučimo, kako će to da se desi, kako ćemo mi kad neko nama napravi narudžbu, kako ćemo mi to dopremiti do te prodavnice, kako ćemo naplatiti taj novac, ništa mi to nismo znali. Ali da bi se to postiglo, mora da se mijenja svijest u korijenu. Da li su naše firme loše, zato ja ne bih volio da kažem da smo loši preduzetnici, da li moramo da imamo bolje, edukovanije ljude, bolje pripremljene za posao, da bi te firme sutra bile bolje. Ja nikad neću priznati da mi nismo dovoljno kreativni ljudi. Naprotiv, sve naše kolekcije su dizajnirali ljudi koji su odrasli i školovali se u Srbiji, ali su jako puno inputa morali da dobiju kod nas u firmi i to nas jako puno na dnevnom nivou košta. Mislim da je prosto neophodno da se ta veza između dizajna, između školstva, industrije uspostavi, jer to neće biti moguće na dugačke staze da se održi, da ekonomija Srbije krene naprijed ukoliko ne budemo imali bolje, edukovanije mlade ljude koji će te naše firme i nas preduzetnike ovakve kakve jesmo povući naprijed.
Yeah, you need a lot of guts, of course, and you need also luck on the way, but by the end of the day it's I think both timing, luck and a lot of professional of course, and I believe in what you say. I mean, you can't know everything, you can't control everything. You need to believe in yourself or the idea or whatsoever. I mean, you can't control it. Just let it happen. And as you say, so much humor into it. It will go well then.
I mean, up to a certain point, I mean, people that know me or my family, we are not hazardous people, you know, we're not gamblers. You know, it's a simple judgment. And of course, it's a matter of how you really want. First time when we went to sell in Germany, we thought it would be great if there is a shop to present it. If we find a proper shop, let's just give it as a present.
And I just want to thank you for coming and thank you our guest for coming the whole way from Sweden, also from Belgrade. I mean, this is actually, the Monday Club is an opportunity for Serbia and Sweden to meet.